Greetings, Vault citizens. Johnny5 Alive, your Vault Overseer here, and welcome back to another episode of Settlement Spotlight. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at Junkyard Sanctuary, created by Indigo. So, stay tuned, and let's check it out. Alright everyone, before we get into it, here's a quick look at the Nexus mod page. Links will be down in the description below. This is the Junkyard Sanctuary Settlement Blueprint. It is a blueprint for Sanctuary. And here's a look at some of the screenshots and what have you. It's a very pretty looking build created by Indigo. You will require a whole bunch of mods, and we'll talk a little bit about that in game. So let's just dive right on into it. All right, everyone, here we are at the junkyard. Here's the entrance. It's kind of parked at the back of Sanctuary here. Got a little heap of junk over here to lead us on in to the entrance. So we're going at nighttime here. I will also show you guys this at daytime. But this looks quite incredible. Look at these little antique shop over here. So many little details in here. And then we have the Super Duper Mart over here. I quite like the sign and the scrap piled up. All these different appliances for sale. Let's go on in here. Super Duper Mart. Got carried away with the OCD decorator, I see. That is quite fantastic. So this is technically our first settlement spotlight of another creator, and it's quite exciting because we get to see what people have done with the various mods. Now this one does have a pretty big mod list considering, but look at the amount of detail you get from this compared to the vanilla. Oh, this goes into the residential. Ah, someone's in a bathtub. Well then, oh, this neat little bedroom here. Look at all those knickknacks. So we got a mod just for the bed. I like how this is built into the side of the house. The residential comes out, they sell here. Work behind the counter. This is quite cool. So how does this actually work? Is this part of the garage or is, I don't know, the Super Duper Mart's built into the house. And then he's added in a door here. That's very immersive. I quite like the layering of this. And this is the actual garage part. And then all the junk is piled up on top. Really doesn't feel like a house anymore. That is quite incredible. Let's see what we can get up top there. Got some funky broken ladders here. Still can manage to get up. Up! Oh, look at this. A little bunk up top. Some ammo, weapons, hats, Minuteman gear. Very nice. Little outpost, looking at the vault up there. Got a little bit of a texture bug going on. Uh-oh. Okay. A few floating pieces. I don't know what's up with that. We're not sure if this transfer settlements is 100% bug proof. We did see a few bugs in my own settlement transfer. But for the most part, it seems to be pretty good. So we might notice a few glitches here and there. So this is the protagonist's starting house, and it's been junkified. Look at all that scrap. Let's go on in and see what we can find here. Oh, Hancock's sleeping on a floating bed. Couple bugs left over here. Look at all the Nuka-Cola bottles hand placed here. Custom little kitchen. I don't know if I should be muting the sound effects. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. We still have some ironing out to do with this series, but we'll figure it out. I think this is a bug as well. Things are loading up green sometimes, and we noticed that with mine as well. I did wait a couple days for the cells to reset. But we're still noticing, see, some of these things loading up green. I don't know what's caused by that. If anyone knows, leave a comment down below. We definitely want to try and get these settlements loaded up without any major bugs, but so far it's pretty decent.
What gave you the idea we're friends?
See if we can go up top. Marcy Long. Gotta put a cage on her soon. Okay. This is neat. Can we go in here? Oh. Get a little cleaning there before going to the med bay. What's this do? Oh. Settlement recruitment beacon. It's like a radio room slash med bay. I love seeing these like hidden little rooms and knickknacks. That is quite an impressive door. I like this water tower. All these pipes custom made here fit in. It's quite a nice contraption.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls?
And then this is the main yellow house that most people end up gravitating towards. It's been built up a little bit. Got a motorcycle being worked on. I like the cinder blocks holding the wheel together. Some really nice details here. Quite like it. Anything on the inside? Ooh. So this is what I love about the OCD decorator and kitchen set. You can make these fancy little knickknacks and corners. This is quite a cozy corner. Nicely decorated. Definitely love the addition of mods here. Now, I did get every single mod that was required for this settlement, but we are noticing a few things floating as if there was supposed to be something here. I nuked my settlement and imported anything that should have been brought in, so I don't know why things are floating. So definitely still a few things to iron out. It could be as simple as there was something here from the original game and he didn't export it with the original assets, or I had deleted something that was originally there. It could be a combination of things, really. Look at all these little plants in the window. It's like a mini greenhouse extension to the house. I like this. Let me look back here. Nicely... The heater's turned into a toilet. That's great. Okay. Lots of great details here. What do we have over here? An electrical.
I was hoping you could help us.
It's a little workshop. Power generator. What is this? We got a house. How do we get in there? Staircase over there. Let's go on up. Anything back here? Oh. Love these little hidden nooks we got here. Is there a way in? I feel like there should be. Oh, that's a door. Would you look at that? Huh. Well, hello. MacReady. MacReady found his own little shack. Oh, I love these little cozy rooms. Weapons rack, ammo. Definitely feels like a MacReady place. It's kind of funny that we found him in here. That's quite awesome. All right, let's see what's up here. Another cozy room. The cigar and handcuffs. Ooh. All right. A lot more detail in here than I actually anticipated, because as I did the loading, the importing, it only said 1,200 objects. I say only, but I'm comparing it to the settlement that I exported that was 5,000 objects. And I was, you know, when I saw 1,000, I was like, I wonder how much detail is going to be here. But a lot of the details here are with the knickknacks. We have this one big bulky building over here. Has quite a bit of detail all around it. All these tiny knickknacks covering it up, making it really gorgeous looking on the outside, as well as a lot of knickknacks on the inside. So we are seeing a lot of details here. I didn't check that room out. Can we get in here? Look at that. Preston Garvey found his own little place. That's where you store the bobbleheads. So yeah, a lot of this mod is really coming down to the details. And I really like this theme he's got going on here with the... Oh, there's a truck hose. Oh, that is quite nice. So you really got to look for the details. Definitely excited for the series so far, you guys. This is a lot of fun seeing what people have made. Let's wait till day. Is there a seat somewhere? I have so many freaking mods loaded up that when I go into settlement mode, it abolishes my computer. And I was looking through it, guys, just to see how complicated it would be to build with mods. There's way, way, way too many mods. So that's where, oh no, we need a clear day thing. Hold on. All right, we have cleared the weather up, and here we are at daytime. I really love the look of this building. It's quite fantastic. Did we end up getting on top? I feel like there are all those hidden nooks that sometimes you could miss things. I want to check up here one more time. What was I saying? Yeah, my mod list is so big that it's freaking impossible to build anything. For me, if I were to build with mods, I would definitely want it simplified. So that brings me to the discussion of this here creation. I think it looks fantastic. These buildings look amazing. I like the little antique shop over there. This building over here looks great. All of them look great, and I guess what I would want, since you're going through all the trouble, I think there's something like 20 mods required to make this work and load up properly. And it, for me, it's a little discouraging that, you know, we got a mod just for this rack here or some of these knickknacks, and there was a Borderlands mod for just a few panels used throughout this area. And it's so, like, that rooftop, I think, is a Borderlands rooftop, and this wall panel. And there's just a lot of different mods here to make this possible. And I do think you could achieve the same feel and the same kind of vibe with a lot less mods. So for me, I feel like this one feels a little bit mod heavy for what you're getting. However, if you were to install those 20 mods, I guess this would be a message to, I think, Indigo, the mod creator. Now that you've put in all these mods, it would be nice to see this expanded a little bit. Have another junk house here, one there, maybe some around here, or maybe a junk tree fort built up, and just kind of roll that theme a little bit further. Because it is a lot of mods to install just for a few houses, and I do feel like, you know, I'd want this to be a little bit more vast and big. However,
yeah. My old man taught me
the buildings that we have here are absolutely remarkable. So, and I could imagine how long they take to build, sorting through all those mods. But definitely a fantastic build here. That's pretty much going to do it for this episode, guys. I do want to talk quickly about modding in general and the Settlement Spotlight series, because I've definitely been going and tinkering around with this quite a painful process, figuring out how I want to do this. So a lot of these settlements, like such as this one, I have to download a whole bunch of mods to use to make it work. However, they might not be mods that I particularly want in my game. So what ends up happening is we have this kind of conflict of interest, where I'm adding all these assets to my game to look at their settlements, and it's making it makes the game harder for me to build. I could check them out and uninstall them and then not have them in my game anymore, but then the next one I look at might need some of those mods again. I have a lot of management to do and things to figure out. I might be able to make two profiles on the Nexus mod tool, disable all the mods and then enable them with mine, and I just don't know if there's going to cause any crossover issues there. If you were to mod your own Fallout game and build your own stuff, I think it's a lot more simple. You get what you need, get what you want, and I'll show you guys the mod list here of what I have. I'm opening up settlement mode and the game completely freezes up. So if you were to do this on your own, you just were interested in building, I think you could get your mod list reduced to maybe 5 or 10 settlement mods that you really, really enjoy, that's going to improve your gameplay and your building experience, and leave it at that. For me, I'm going to have to download like 40 mods just to, you know, make sure I have my assets covered for checking out all these people's creations, which does conflict with my own game. As you saw there, just to go into settlement mode, that must have taken 10 or 20 seconds at least. And these are all the different menus, and I think I got to get a menu sorter as well. I thought I installed like an SKE menu sorter, but it didn't didn't seem to work the way I wanted it to. But here's your basic menus, and they just go on forever. So if we go into structures, there's wooden structures. It has all the base stuff that we would expect from the game, but then there's all these extra menus popped in here. Like in the miscellaneous, there's just so much stuff that's extra with the mods. And if you really want to get crazy and look at things, guys, it's nuts under the decorations, like armor racks. Like, look at all this stuff. And it goes on for days. I sat here for about 2 hours just looking through what's in my game now, from downloading mods for this settlement and just what I saw in the workshop that looked kind of cool. It's definitely overkill. So for me, I would definitely want to reduce this as much as possible. But there are some pretty crazy things in here that I like. But when you're downloading all these billboards and things, you're much like Planet Coaster, you spend most of your time looking through the menus. And for me, I would definitely want to get a menu sorter mod. By default, the vanilla sorting is good. And then when you add in a few mods, I would like it to categorize them all together. But I think what's really crazy, I would like to get into just like the simple stuff. We have OCD Decorator in here, which you can see here. And there's just so many knickknacks for decorating shelves with. And this is just one menu of like 20. Luckily with OCD Decorator, it's organized quite nicely, like kitchen and dining, and then you got food, beverages, and then you go into food and or beverages, and you find all your different beverages. So it's quite nicely organized. And then there's the fact of like, I can't build this one because I don't have ice cold liquor. So is there a mod that allows me to build without materials? I don't know. So in terms of me building right now in the game, I got a lot of things to figure out. How I'm going to do it with all these mods plugged in for the spotlights versus what I need for playing and how they're going to conflict with one another. So it's a little bit unfortunate, but at the end of the day, I can definitely do the spotlights. However, I'm interested in actually playing the game, and I have to figure out my workaround. But at the end of the day, what's really cool is checking out these settlements. We could definitely load up someone's creations and see what they did a lot faster than I can build them. And I think this one here by Indigo was a great start. We saw some really nice compositions here, the junk heap, and I'm looking forward to digging through the workshop and seeing what else people have made. And you definitely draw a lot of inspiration to create your own. So let me know what you guys think of this episode and what you think of getting on to other people's settlements, as well as if you would like to see me build my own. We got lots of unanswered questions here, things to experiment with, things to try. It's all a learning process. Boom. So there you go, guys. That's going to do it for this episode of Settlement Spotlights. If you enjoyed, please be sure to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe for more daily videos. And if you would like to support the show because you enjoy these videos, you could do so by becoming a patron. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you all have a great day, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye now.